A cheerful morning to all. A warm welcome to the English Digital Classroom. You might be eagerly waiting for today's session. Am I right? In the previous session, we have discussed the phase sheet of Unit 3, School Life, didn't we? In the phase sheet, we discussed what are the nuisances that are caused by the students in schools, and you tried to reasonize the punishments given by the teacher. Today, we are going to read the lesson that was extracted from Swami and His Friends, a novel that was written by R. K. Narayan, the great Indian literarian. In this story, you would come to know the similar experiences that are caused by the students in the schools and what the results are. Before you are going to read the story, let us know about the great author. Children, now look at the picture and guess who is he? Yes, you are right. Is R. K. Narayan a great Indian writer? Is the writer of Swami and His Friends, the great literary work, a novel from which our present story is extracted? Before we are going to read the lesson, let us know the literary works that are written by him. Now, look at this image. What is this, children? Exactly, it is a poster of the movie Guide. It was the biggest Bollywood hit of 1965. You might have not seen it so far. If you watch this movie, you would come to know the grand storyteller behind it is R. K. Narayan, who is credited with bringing Indian literature in English to the rest of the world. Now, look at another image. What is this, children? You are again correct. It is a poster of highly cherished TV serial, Malgudi Days. Have you ever watched the TV serial? If you watch it, you would have an experience of creating fictions. The striking feature of R. K. Narayan's story is every character seems to be very much with us. His narratives are highlights the social context of his time. In 60 years of literary career, R. K. Narayan created many novels. Some of his popular works are The Dark Room. It is a story of two women. The English Teacher. It is a novel. Waiting for the Mahatma. A novel of Gandhi. The Manager of Malgudi. It is a novel. The Bachelor of Arts. It is a novel. R. K. Narayan was presented with Sahitya Academy Award for his marvelous work, The Guide. He also honored with A.C. Benson Medal. He was conferred with Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian award. Children, you have just seen the literary popular works of R. K. Narayan. R. K. Narayan's present story, Swami and His Friends, it is a satirical work that poked on the corporal punishment of those days. In those days, it was believed that spare the rod, spoil the child. It means if we do not use the cane, the children get spoiled. Children, now don't you feel enthusiastic to read the novel and the story that was written by R. K. Narayan? Before we begin the session, let's see what the objectives are. You'll make intelligent prediction by reading the picture in the passages. Based on your perception, you guess what is going to happen and hence prepare the subtext. You read the passage and comprehend. Analyze the information, link it with personal experiences. Reflect on the passages. Finally, you construct a minor discourse, that is a notice. Before you read the text, you please look at the text and look at the pictures that are given in between the passages. Based on the reading of your pictures, you answer the questions. Have you seen it? What is it, children? What is the headmaster doing? Why is the headmaster punishing him? What are the other students doing? Why are some students standing on the benches? Who do you think is the boy in the blue shirt? Why is he peeping? Now, children, look at the picture given in page number 49. Have you observed it? Now, answer the questions. What is Swaminathan doing? Why is he crying? Where is he going? Why is he going home? Based on the subtext that you have prepared, let us see how you can make the paragraph. It is a classroom. In the picture, the headmaster is punishing a student. It seems he did some mischievous thing. Some students are standing and some are sitting because they might be absent from school. The boy in blue shirt might be Swami. It seems he is afraid to see the headmaster. Swami is crying. The headmaster punished him because he did some mischievous thing. Swami seems to be going home since the headmaster expelled him. Now, have a look at the glossary, which will help you while reading. Flushed, turned red. When he saw someone broke his watch, his face flushed with anger. Humiliated, make someone feel ashamed and foolish by injuring their dignity and pride. Akhil is humiliated by his friends. Flogged, beat with a stick as punishment. The student was flogged by the teacher for his misdeed. Pronounce, announce. RBI governor is pronouncing the release of 200 rupee note. Resolutely, intentionally or purposefully. When all the girls are listening to the teacher, the dark girl is looking outside resolutely. Intolerable, unbearable. The heat is intolerable. I shall sit before a fan. Acute, very strong or severe. She is suffering from acute eye pain. Impulse, strong desire. He has a great impulse to eat ice cream. Sinister, looking likely to cause something bad. When my friend rushed to me with a sinister look, I was afraid something bad was going to happen to me. Panes, glasses. Someone broke the window panes. Jest, feeling of enjoyment and excitement. When she found what she was searching for a long, she could not control her jest. Defiant, refusing to obey someone. The mother is shouting upon the defiant child who is not following her orders. Threatening, warning. The girl is threatening the boy for behaving badly with her. Children, so far we discussed the new words that you come across while reading the text. Now, you read the passages from Swami is expelled from school from page number 47 to 49. Children, now let's watch the video that was presented by school students, Swami is expelled from school.
Are you not ashamed of telling anything there? After what you did yesterday?
Yes, yes, special honor to them. I read out the names of the students. Somo, Rajam, Shankar, Mane, Swaminath, Kanyal, Tanjit, Rohit. Shut up on the
No, no, no. Shut up on the You're making much noise, creating many problems to others, and not eating well. Your behavior is not good. You must be disciplined. If this continue, I dismiss from the school. So, why did you come to school yesterday?
I had an attack of headache, sir. So, I couldn't come to school yesterday.
Why didn't you come to school yesterday? If you are going to listen every loafer who said there would be no school, you deserve to be flogged. Your 10 days attendance cancelled. You have to pay 2 rupees fine. And whole day spent on the bench. What happened to you?
I had an attack of headache, sir.
Bring a letter from your father.
Yes, sir.
Shankar, what about you?
I have stomach aches, sir.
Are you okay now?
Yes, sir. I'm okay now.
Samuel, what about you?
My grandmother was dead. Suddenly, I was starting first school.
Bring a letter from your father.
No, I have no father.
Who is your guardian?
My grandmother.
The grandmother was dead, but she is not.
No, it is another grandmother.
How many grandmothers would a person have? Bring a letter from your neighbors.
I cannot. None of my neighbors could read or write because I lived in a illiterate part of Element Street.
I will send a teacher to know the fact. He will inquire the neighbors.
No, the neighbors do not know. Since my grandmother died in the village.
You are a street dog. I suspended you for 15 days. Swami, why did you keep away yesterday? Tell me, why were you absent?
Won't you open your mouth? I will kill you.
I couldn't come, sir.
Is the show?
Hey, bring the mule.
Don't say about this rascal. He's standing on the desk.
I didn't say you to break.
Open my ventilator.
Don't beat me, sir. It pains.
What is your answer? Keep standing on the desk. Like an idiot. Till I announce your dismissal.
I don't care about that people.
Children, now you have seen the play. Am I right? How is it? Have you enjoyed it? It is an eye-opening to both the teacher and as well as the students. Children, now answer the following questions. How did the headmaster enter the class?
Headmaster entered the class with a slightly flushed face and a hard, ominous look in his eyes because he could not bear the students' misbehavior and punish them.
What was the punishment given to the second student?
The punishment given to the second student was his 10-day sentence was cancelled. He was fined with 2 rupees. He was also asked to spend whole day on the desk.
Do you think the answers of the fifth student are true? Why had he to give such evasive answers?
No, I don't think. I think he gave an evasive answer to cover his first incorrect answer.
Why do you think Swami could not answer the questions of the headmaster?
I think he has no proper reason to give for his actions. He knows that even if he gives the wrong answer, he would be caught.
He had unconsciously become defiant. Who was he? What made him to become defiant?
He was Swaminathan. He became defiant because he could not take serious punishments or he might be defiant by nature.
Children, now it's time for assignment. Justify the reaction of headmaster for students' misbehavior. What would you do if you were in the place of headmaster? Do you support the behavior of Swami? What would you do if you were in his place? Swami thought of giving different explanations to HM for his absence, but he did not give any. Children, now it's time for discourse. Let's prepare a notice. Before that, let us see what the format of notice is. In the format, first you write name of the issuing authority or its address. Next to that, you write notice. Notice you write in capital letters. On the left, you write the date. Then you begin the body of notice. If you want to write the body of the notice, you have to answer all these questions. First, whom, why, what, when, where, and finally instruction. Whom refers to the audience or the receivers. Why refers to the purpose. Why are you writing the notice? What means on what event you are writing the notice. When, what is the time or date that is scheduled. Where, the place where the event take place, instruction. Finally, you are going to write what is to be noticed to the audience. At the end, you put a signature and write your designation. Children, now you have seen the format of discourse. Before that, let's discuss the features of the notice. A notice is meant for conveying information or giving an instruction. When information is meant for a large group of people or organization, we write notice. Points to remember. Language of notice should be impersonal. Use passive voice as far as possible. Address the audience first. begin the notice with catchy phrase to arrest the interest of audience. Use persuasive language, not to write first person I and the second person you. Use appropriate format or a layout. Now you have seen how the notice to be written. Will you answer some of the questions based on the notice? What is the issuing authority? Who are the audience or who are the receivers? Where should you write the date? What is the notice about? What is the instruction? What kind of language is used in? Who signed the notice? The answers are: Headmaster Albert Mission School. Second answer is the school students. Third, we should write the date at the top left. The fourth one is the notice about informing the irregular student to get their parents for counseling meeting and cautioning the students causing nuisance. They should get parents on Monday at 10 a.m. The students causing nuisance will be dismissed. The sixth is language used is persuasive. The seventh is the headmaster signed the notice. Now it's time for assignment. Imagine that you are the secretary of cultural committee of your school. On the occasion of Children's Day, the school staff has decided to conduct self-government day. Prepare a notice that is to be served to the students on behalf of the headmaster, instructing the students to participate in the program. Have you enjoyed the today's session? Hope you have enjoyed. I will be waiting for the next session to see you again. You prepare the assignment with the help of your teacher. Bye.